We too today are called upon to palpitate with joy, to be able to welcome the divine spirit that visited the Maiden of God, thanks to whom we are here now, and we are invited to remake ourselves children, to make ourselves be visited by the same divine spirit that wants us to be reborn from above, to make everyone welcome the mystery of the New Jerusalem, in which the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit who have taken up permanent dwelling, in which dwells the divine spirit, in which the outpouring of the divine spirit is perennial. Foolish are those who teach, have taught and continue to teach that the outpouring of the Spirit has stopped at that day of Pentecost, when the Spirit visited the first friends of Jesus. The history of God has always been shaken by the breath of the Holy Spirit that has animated the saints and led humanity to live the fulfillment of fulfillments. That's why one must understand the action of the Spirit, follow Him, in order to be able to welcome, as this maiden has done, and as we are invited to do today. That is why Jesus already then informed his friends of the living action of the Spirit that would have helped humanity to fully understand the truth. I will send him to you, and when he has come, he will convince the world as to sin, to justice and judgment. Why does the world have to be persuaded of what seems obvious, one would ask oneself. Already the world should be convinced as to sin in terms of the justice and judgment, but those words make us understand the world would not remain intact in those teachings, but would have collapsed, would once again have returned to a worse condition than the initial one that Jesus found. That's why there was a need, there is a need of the living action of the Comforter, of the Paraclete, of the Advocate of the children of God, to help the children convince themselves of what Jesus had already taught them, but had been forgotten. As for sin, because they do not believe in me. The times that Jesus had to face were those of a living disbelief in the matter of his person. Jesus said to the Jews, I go and you'll look for me, but you'll die in your sins. Where I am going you cannot come. You are from down here, I'm from up there. You're from this world, I'm not from this world. I told you that you will die in your sins if in fact you don't believe that I am. You will die in your sins.